Ambassador Porro, we're here to speak about International Day of Women in Diplomacy. And so I wanted to ask you as ambassador, what inspired you to pursue a career in diplomacy, which is a world which is prevalently male dominated?
Well, it's wonderful to be celebrating women in diplomacy each year. And I have to say, my interest for diplomacy and international relations was sparked at quite an early age. I spent a few years living in Indonesia, and I think that's really where my interest for international relations and diplomacy developed. But you're right to say that the diplomatic world has traditionally been very male dominated, and I still remember very clearly my first day walking into the Foreign Service in Australia, walking down a corridor with portraits of men. and it is incredibly intimidating, also in particular because you can't be what you can't see. I'm very fortunate to belong to a Foreign Service that has addressed this issue head on. Over the past 5-6 years, there's been a real push to promote women in leadership. And now, about 5 or 6 years ago, we had less than 20% female ambassadors. We now make up over 40% of all our ambassadors around the world. So there's been a huge push and recognition of the value and contribution that women make in diplomacy. And I'm proud to be one of these female ambassadors representing Australia overseas.
Speaking of women in diplomacy, what actually is the difference between men and women in this field of work? In the sense, what do women bring that men do not? And especially, how do they complement each other?
I think it's a lot about diversity. So women are obviously bring a different perspective based on their gender and their experiences in life. It's important not to stereotype women. We're not all the same, so we bring a wide variety of different qualities, as do men. But I think we bring a different perspective. And one of the things that's particularly important in diplomacy is that we represent the face of our countries. So it's important that we represent the diversity of our country, and of course women make up a large percentage of that. And also, it enables us to reach parts of society around the world that are not always accessible to men. And that's particularly important in conflict situations, on development issues. We know that women are always the first and more severely affected during conflict, during humanitarian disasters. And so I think having women working in diplomacy, leading diplomatic efforts, is incredibly important to be able to reach those who are most affected in these situations. And also to give, to bring that different perspective to a lot of these conversations.
How do you see the future of women in diplomacy?
Well, I think it's been incredibly inspiring over the past 3 years to work with my fellow women ambassadors here. There's around 25 of us now, even more if you count some of the chargés, and we're quite a formidable group. It's been a huge source of support for me here. And so I think the future is bright if you look at the way that we've been able to challenge bias and stereotypes and bring our voices and demonstrate what we bring as women leaders. I think there's still a long way to go, but there's hope. There's real, I think there's growing recognition of what women bring to the table. And I think countries are realizing that they need to have diversity in their representation overseas. So I think the future is bright.